Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. My name's Cole and today I'm going to be talking about some indie romances that I forgot I loved. So when I was making my 30th birthday video, I was thinking about this period of time in my life where all I read was indie romance, kind of free books on iBooks or Kindle that were kind of first in a series and then you'd pay for the next ones. And when I was thinking about them, there were some that I just absolutely loved at the time and I thought I'd just make a video about them. I'm not sure how readily available these books are, but hopefully if you are interested in them you will be able to pick them up either through Kindle or elsewhere. The first book series is the Lost and Found series by Nicole Williams. This is about a girl called Rowan. For the last 5 years she's been on this downward spiral of self-sabotage and destruction and not really caring about the consequences of her actions. Her mum is kind of at the last resort with her and sends her off to this ranch. I think it's one of her friends who owns it. She kind of makes a deal with her that if she goes to the ranch for the summer and behaves herself, then she will pay for her to go to art school. On the ranch is the rancher's hand. Maybe he's the son of the ranch owner, I can't really remember, but our main love interest, Jesse, is the complete opposite of Rowan. He's such a happy, optimistic, kind of nice guy, and Rowan is interested in him, but she thinks that he's too good for her and that she doesn't deserve him. There is a lot of angst between them, which is why I just really enjoyed this series, because it's kind of one of those ones where it's like a good guy, bad girl, which you don't see as often, I don't think. Don't get me wrong, there is a lot of like kind of issues with this series and it is just melodramatic, but if that is your bag then I think you will really enjoy it. Some of the stuff is just absolutely absurd that happens, but that is kind of what I like in an indie romance, that it is just complete melodrama. I think the first one of this actually is free on Kindle, so if that is something that sounds interesting to you, I would definitely recommend picking it up and giving it a go. The next series is the Saving Wishes series by GJ Walker. I think this might be the only one that I probably have briefly mentioned on my channel, because this series I just absolutely loved and have reread it since, not that recently, but I do just really enjoy the characters in it. The story follows our main character, Charlie, and she is living in this small town of Piper's Cove. She doesn't really like living there. She has one school year left and then she's off travelling with her best friend, Nicole. She just can't wait to get out of this kind of small town life and just see the wider world and what's out there. Then this new guy, Adam, comes to town. He is the cousin of Gabrielle, who is Charlie's French teacher. And there is just kind of this instant connection between them. Charlie is living with her brother as her mother has passed away. As this book goes on and as we continue into the series, there are secrets that kind of come out and create a lot of drama. We're then also following different perspectives, which is one of the things that I really love about these kind of indie romance series, is usually we have the first book where you're following kind of one couple and then we might follow a different couple and then later on we'll see the first one. This just really allows me to see the kind of character growth throughout the series and it's just something that I really enjoy. The romantic relationships in this are really well done, but also this kind of element of family and not always kind of doing what family thinks is best or listening to them just because they are your family, but kind of making your own. So I guess it does have that found family trope a little bit as well. The next series is Fall Into You by Jacinda Wilder. This follows the story of Nell. Nell and Kyle are best friends and they have grown up together, but then Kyle gets into an accident and unfortunately dies and Nell blames herself for it. Only person that really understands what Nell's going through is Kyle's brother Colton. He has his own kind of demons that he's dealing with as well, but they kind of find this connection through their grief. I can't really remember the level of the smut of the previous two that I've mentioned, but this one definitely sticks out as it being a little bit cringy, so if smuttiness is not kind of your thing, then I don't think you will enjoy this one as much. I think at one point Mel refers to herself as a slut beast or something, so take that as you will. Nell and Colton have this kind of amazing connection through music. They're not kind of able to open up about their feelings, but they use music to do that, and I thought that was an interesting idea and I really like that concept. They have obviously a lot going on, dealing with the death and grief, but then also this kind of connection that they've got to each other then makes them kind of feel guilty. The next series is Timeless by E.L. Todd. This one I think does have a bit of smut in it as well. This is just kind of an all-consuming, angst-ridden friends-to-lovers romance. I love an angsty romance. It's definitely something that I look for when I am reading any kind of romance book. Francesca works in a bakery and she meets a guy called Hawk. There is that instant connection between them when they go on their date, but then kind of self-doubt sort of weighs in, and Hawk then finds out that Francesca is the little sister of one of his friends. So we also get that kind of forbidden romance thrown in there as well, which is also something that I enjoy. The series is just full of so much angst and secrets. Hawk has a dark past that is threatening to ruin everything. Oh, I just love that in a love interest. I don't know why, but when they have kind of this dark past or secrets that are going to come out, or everything's kind of a little bit gritty, I just really enjoy that. The first book in the series, Monday, does leave off on a cliffhanger that will make you immediately want to pick up Tuesday, assuming you enjoy the series at all. I would definitely recommend it. And the final series that I'm going to recommend for today is Breaking Rules by Tracy Puckett. Mandy has been living her life according to a set of rules that she devised when she had her heart broken, because then she's hoping that if she follows these rules, she won't get her heart broken again. This does mean as a main character, she can be a little bit frustrating because she doesn't let anybody in, doesn't let anybody kind of close to her. So that does get a little bit annoying, but when you kind of look at it, the character is supposed to be 18, so I kind of have to look at it through those eyes and think that is understandable, and it is because of the things that she's been through, and that is what has made her the way that she is. Mandy then meets the other main character, Gabe. He is kind of dark and mysterious. He keeps her at an arm's length, so he's got his kind of own things going on as well. There isn't as much in their romance in the first book. It definitely progresses more as the series sort of continues. This one is definitely more of a slow burner romance. There is a few kind of miscommunications, neither of them wanting to let the other one in, so things don't kind of progress as smoothly or as quickly as in sort of other romances. But if that is sort of more what you're into, I think you will enjoy this. Because when we do kind of get more into their romance and feelings for each other, it is a really good romance, and I did really sort of enjoy that once we got to that. Slow burn is not my favourite, but then instant love isn't either, so I don't really know what which one I prefer. So that's all the recommendations for today. Let me know down in the comments if you have any recommendations for me, or what your favourite sort of indie romance book is or book series. Thank you for watching the video, and I will see you in my next one. Bye.